Let's talk about the steps that you need to follow on the D-Day, the day of the vaccination, and we will share our experience with you. So the first thing that you need to do is to actually reach the vaccination center, right? And the thing to keep in mind here is to be very careful of the address. So when we booked our slot, it doesn't really mention the complete address. It just gives, I think, a PIN code or just the area reference, something like that, right? And that can be confusing. So make sure that you double check and, you know, you figure out where exactly you have to go. I've had friends who reached the wrong address and they ended up missing their slot. So do not do that. Be careful of the address.
Another important thing is to reach your vaccination center at least 30 to 45 minutes before your slot timing. That is because once you reach there, you will get a manual token and then they will call you token wise. So for example, if your token number is say 60, you will be called in the 60th position. So the earlier token number you have, the faster you will get your vaccination done.
Yeah. So we reached, I think, by 9 a.m., right? Which, our token was around 70, like 70. You mentioned. So we waited for almost two and a half hours. But if we had reached a little earlier, say by 8:15 or 8:30, we would have got a faster token or rather an earlier token number. So try and reach half an hour, 40 minutes before your actual slot.
So once you are called, you have to go to the counter. They will check your original ID proof. If it's Aadhaar, even the digital version is fine, against your booking, and you have to make the appropriate payment. We took Covishield and that costed us 850 rupees in Apollo. So rupees 600 is the cost of vaccine plus 250 is the cost of administration. So once you have made the payment, you are taken to the medical checkup room. In that checkup room, they will do a very quick check of your blood pressure and your oxygen level. Assuming like both are fine, you are sent to the vaccination room. At the vaccination room, the nurses will show you the vial with the expiry date and they will administer the vaccine for you. The entire process takes under 1 minute.
And after that, they told us to wait for another 30 minutes. This is again for observation to make sure that, you know, nothing is wrong. And this you can either wait inside or wait out in your car. And I think after 30 minutes, we just went inside, informed them that we were fine. And then we were free to leave. So this basically was our experience of getting the shot. And yeah, and now I think quickly we can tell them what happened after we came back home.
Yes.
Yeah. Why don't you start?
So, actually, like nothing happened till evening.
Yeah. Till night, actually.
Till night, nothing happened.
10 p.m.
Around 10-ish, both of us got slight fever and we had ache in our arm and body aches.
Headache
and body ache, which lasted, I think, the entire night and half the day next day.
Yeah.
So, symptoms around like mild headache, body ache, and fever for around 24 hours from the night of vaccination.
Yeah.
That's what happened with me. Yeah.
Similar for me, just that my headache was more severe. And but again, these are the things which are expected and you're also warned about this when you get your shot. So just be prepared. You can take a paracetamol or a dolo tablet, you know, if it gets too much for you. But yeah, overall, I think a pretty smooth process. Of getting the vaccination, and the wait time for the next shot is about 2 months, right?
Yeah, 45 days. So we also get an SMS from informing us about our next vaccination date. This SMS has come from Apollo, like where we got vaccinated. However, I think you have to schedule again on the Cowin app your second vaccination. I don't think it's a normal walk-in process, but I may be wrong. So if you are aware, comment down and let us know also. The vaccination certificate you will get on the Cowin app. So download it from there. And it should also be available on the government DigiLocker app.
Okay.
And that could be very, very important for your travel. So especially for international travel, this will become like a vaccine passport, which our guess is that will become mandatory by the end of this year.
Yeah. Especially for all the, you know, students, for all the people traveling to the US, be very vigilant about this. Keep it handy because, like he's saying, I think it's going to become a norm by the end of this year. So guys, this was all about getting yourself vaccinated. I really hope that the tips and hacks that we have shared with you help you. So go ahead, get yourself vaccinated. Also share this video with as many people as you can. Spread the information. And yeah, stay safe, keep the masks on, stay at home. And I'll see you very soon in the next video. Till then, make sure that you subscribe and hit the bell icon so that you don't miss on any updates. Signing off for now. Bye.